Today, we're going to look at four important Illustrator logo design tools, but if you want to skip the intro, move to the timestamp in the corner. These Illustrator tools don't have to strictly be used for logo design, but they're very important when it does come to logo designing. I'm not only going to show you them, I'm going to show you how to use them in today's tutorial. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. I want to say a quick thank you to all of my subscribers and viewers, because you guys have now pushed this channel past the 500,000 views across all of my videos. This is a huge milestone and I'm super hyped about it. So thank you to everybody who tunes in often to my content, learns something, posts a comment and a like, and shares my videos. It really does mean a lot to me. Now, let's jump right into my list of four important Illustrator logo design tools. The first tool for logo design that we're going to be looking at is the Shape Builder tool. I've made a group of circles here with the Ellipse tool. You can experiment with a whole host of shapes to create different logo designs, but the idea is to create shapes and spaces within other shapes. Here is the Shape Builder tool here. But you first need to select all of your shapes and then select the Shape Builder tool. You will notice by default there's a plus sign above the cursor. You can now draw within the areas that you want to use to join together for your logo design. To remove the areas that you don't want for your logo design, hold down the Alt Option key until you see this icon appear. Then carefully go around your design removing areas that you don't want. The Shape Builder tool is great in Illustrator because you can quickly make shapes for logo designs that you could not make in the Pathfinder window. You can then flick the stroke over to a fill and then go about adding text to your design, essentially completing the logo. This is obviously not amazing logo design, I just wanted to show you guys how to use the Shape Builder tool for logo designing. The Pathfinder tool is something I've used on my channel quite often. Granted, there are some things that you cannot do with it, and that's why I showed you the Shape Builder tool previously. The Pathfinder has many settings, but I'm going to show you just a few for logo designing right now. But I can, however, go into each individual setting in the Pathfinder in a future video. So if you guys want to see that, let me know. You can find the Pathfinder tool here. And I'm going to show you three ways in which is important for logo designing in Illustrator. For the first example, I'm going to rotate this square real quick. You can draw shapes with the pen tool that will eventually cut into or cut out of the original shape to make a new shape for our logo design. You can hold down the shift to select both shapes at once, and then turn them over to a fill. Group the two shapes together, and then select everything and use the minus one option in the Pathfinder window. So as you can see, it's very simple to use the Pathfinder tool to make a quick logo design. If you have a solid idea beforehand, that just makes it a lot easier. Again, I'm going to add some text real quick, and actually I feel like a serif font is best for this type of logo design. I will now show you how to cut your logo into a shape with the Pathfinder tool. So make sure you have the Pathfinder window open in Illustrator, and then bring down the logo mark to the front like so. It's a good idea to change it to white so you will see how the finished outcome is going to look. And then rearrange the layout and the size until you're happy for the design. select both of them, and then again use the minus one option in the Pathfinder window. As you can see here, the logo is now cut into the circle, making it one entire shape. The final way to use the Pathfinder tool in Illustrator for logo designing is going to be the crop setting. As you can see here, I have three shapes just for the purposes of this example, so two circles and one square. You will need to make sure that the two circles are behind the square by sending them to the back like so. You then need to select everything and then use the crop option. This method can create some very interesting designs, so experiment and play around with it to see what you can make. Remember to let me know if you want to see a tutorial based around the Pathfinder window exclusively. The direct selection tool is essential for editing logo designs in Illustrator, and here's why. You can find the direct selection tool here, and it performs different operations in comparison to the selection tool to the left. If you hover your direct selection tool over your logo, you're going to see words like path and anchor. If you select the path, you can stretch and edit the logo design in this manner. If you then select within the shape itself, you can move the entire design. And if you select the anchor, you can edit the logo and its appearance. If you use a direct selection tool in this way, you can really change the way your logo looks, editing it more and more as you approach the final logo outcome. It's always best to make a lot of pre-designed concepts on paper first, and then when you design the actual logo, move it to Illustrator when you have several solid concepts. A list about important Illustrator tools for logo design would not be complete without the pen tool. The pen tool allows you to make designs and shapes along a vector path. If you perfect your skills with the pen tool, you literally have no limits to what you can design for your logo. Here there's a sketch of an elephant which might be part of your pre-design process for your logo design project. So upload it to Illustrator and then carefully go around it with a pen tool, making sure that you pay close attention to detail. As you also saw in the first part of the tutorial, the pen tool is also handy when using the Pathfinder tool for logo designing, as you can freehand draw shapes to cut into other shapes. The pen tool really is useful across Illustrator for almost any type of design. So let me know if you found this video on 4 important Illustrator tools for logo design helpful. I'm going to try and finish a video on the logo design process from start to finish next week. I have been working on this for quite a long time, but time is against me quite often. So let me know if that's something you'd like to see on this channel. Also, drop a like on the video and share my content if you do find it useful. Subscribe to Satori Graphics for 3 weekly graphic design uploads. And make sure to have a great weekend, everybody. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.